the party tries to figure out where to go on our next island-hopping adventure. We remember an island of lizard folk who are at war with each other. Me. Wait, I just got my dragon-slaying sword. Going there could serve as its test run. DM, I think lizard folk count as humanoid. Me? Not if you're racist. Party starts laughing out of, presumably, horror? In all seriousness, did I cross the line with this joke? No, OP. I think you hit that sweet spot of dark, but not burnt. And for that, we salute you. Hello, my cubs, and welcome back to another episode of the Bear Bard Tales. It is I, the one bear on the internet, not getting into the NFT game. I guess. Unless Drake and Crow talk me into it. The Bear Bard. Yes, it's true, I am back. I know the world is wondering, will he actually get back to a real schedule, or is he just playing with our hearts? And to that I say, come closer for this. Look me in the eyes. You know I never let you down. I got you, I promise. That I'll probably, hopefully be better. But for real, I want to apologize. I had a fairly major change-up life event along with a two-month-long migraine, and I've just honestly had trouble keeping up. I am redoubling and will be trying harder to keep to the weekly schedule. Also, this channel has officially turned one. Yay! It's insane to me that it's already been a year. I've learned so much. Seriously, my first videos were really, really bad. Grown a ton and have met some amazing people from the experience. And I have all of you to thank for that. I truly appreciate all the love and support you've shown the videos I have been able to get out there. It really does mean a ton to me. I also have some really cool stuff upcoming for the channel that I hope you're gonna love. So make sure to stay tuned. But enough about the boring stuff like me. Before we get to today's story, if you like this type of content and you want to hear more from the Bear Bard, make sure to serenade that like button and give the channel a sub. Every sub I get gets me one step closer to buying MySpace and restoring it back to its 2006 glory days, when you can make your profile cooler with sparkles by becoming an HTML programmer and showing everyone what your favorite song was at the time, or at least what song you were supposed to like at the time. Then sit back and let the drama of the top 8 ensue. Look, I understand that this joke won't land with everyone, but if it did with you, BioFreeze is great for joint pain, and they even have a roll-on application so you don't have to get your hands all nasty. Now that I've wasted enough time, let's get to today's story, titled, Player Takes Joke Campaign Too Seriously and Ridicules Everyone, then tries to bribe the DM to remove me from the table due to naming my Firbolg Paladin Sir Loin, and me not taking the game seriously. Recently, I reconnected with my ex, who we'll call Chloe, whom we would constantly play WTA VTM together until we had a mutual breakup a while ago. After going our separate ways and kinda drifting apart, I get a text from her asking if I wanted to join her D&D group, as she needed another player. I join and there's about four other players. You have three regular people playing human, variant human, and a changeling. But one of them kinda took the spotlight and shone it on themselves the entire time session zero. The player, Viagra of Stiffwood, was just being completely extra. The entire time, he cut off others while they were creating slash explaining their characters, trying to inject how his character would have done such and such when explaining backstories, or how he'd always have a comment or critique being piped up every few seconds. He would make comments such as, "You guys' characters are pretty generic. Just wait till you hear about mine. You shouldn't play a rogue because I'm gonna multi-class into one. Playing a human is kinda bland. You should probably change your race, etc., etc." One player and I had to tell him multiple times to shut up, as he was very obviously kind of being a dick. He was second to last to describe his character, asking the DM a bunch of ridiculous questions and asking if she could homebrew a race for him, as he wanted to play a half-elf, half-tiefling and cherry-pick all the buffs from both classes, attempting to get the 4-hour long rest, infernal resistance, and both subrace bonuses, which I can't exactly remember. He asked if he could have a double-bladed scimitar to start off with, and when declined, for somewhat obvious reasons, he told Chloe, "I'll just dual-wield scimitars and take the dual-wielding fighting style and flavor it to be double-bladed." She agreed, however, obviously annoyed. He spent a solid 15 minutes talking about his character, literally reading a script he wrote down on either Google Docs or Discord, and constantly asked the DM about locations he would have come from, been, etc., etc. He then showed us his character, which he had made in Skyrim, and to his credit, was definitely well made and took serious time and effort. Couple things here. it's good to be excited about your character. For a lot of people, the PC themselves is the main draw to the game, so it's good to be into your character. It's always weird when you get someone rolling up game time. I have an elf, a ranger, I guess? Here's the build I got off Reddit. I feel like there's better games for players like that than 5e, but to stomp over others in pursuit of showing off that character, then tearing other people's characters because they're not as unique as yours. I'm even on the humans are boring bandwagon, but I don't hold it against others for wanting to play them. I just don't bother. This guy's already screaming main character syndrome before even starting, but I'm sure he'll turn it around, right? When it came time to present my character, I introduced Sir Loin, a Firbolg paladin on a conquest to bring down the beef industry and liberate his brethren. Viagra spoke up, cutting me off as I started explaining why he joined the party, simply to go on a small tangent, asking if I was stupid and why I'd want to play a character like that, and to take the game seriously because the DM worked hard to provide this experience, so take it fucking seriously. Chloe muted herself and later told me she was laughing her ass off, because I already knew that the campaign wasn't going to be taken too serious, as the name of the campaign was a literal penis joke that seemed to go over his head. The Chronicle of the Sorcerer's Crystal Phallus. Everyone else was joking around for the rest of Session Zero, except for Viagra, who kinda just stayed quiet, only speaking up to mention his character every so often and getting little to no response. A few days later, I get a DM from him, a decently sized wall of text giving off complaints about literally everything, ranging from my character to even me as a person. He pretty much told me that he didn't want to play with someone like me, and neither did the rest of the party, so it would just be best for me to leave so they can enjoy the campaign, and how it would be better if I never joined in the first place. I pretty much give him about a paragraph about how it's not his choice in the matter, and how he kinda has a stick up his ass for taking it too seriously, and that my character was absolutely perfect with zero flaws whatsoever. About an hour later, Chloe asked me to hop into a call. I join and she starts doing that thing where she's giggling and telling me to hear this shit out. Basically sent her the exact same thing he sent me, but changed some words around so it made sense, asking her to essentially either talk to me or shadow ban me. She basically tells him to be mindful of himself, and that they're not going to have this discussion on how he needs to get along with me. She also told me to be careful and stay on my toes as I was somewhat provoking him. The biggest kicker was him offering to cash up her $20 just to get rid of me. Bro, $20? Shoot, say no more, fam. But seriously, I will never understand these people that try this through text. This group doesn't want you. I can now show this message to the group and show them that you suck. If you're gonna be a dick, be like Gina Linetti and say it to their face. But here's where party makeup is so important, as well as Session Zero. You really need people whose idea of the game line up. I mean, not everyone has to agree 100%, but you need personalities and gaming ones that mesh. Now, the OP called the player Viagra of Stiffwood, which is a great name. I can't tell if that was his actual character name or if the OP is just calling him a dick. I'm going with the OP just calling him a dick. But it sounds like he's more the Tumblr melodrama slash everything has to be so serious side of things, joining a goofy campaign. For the invite to even get to Session Zero, this DM should have made it clear that it was a goofy campaign. Then to top off this whole sandwich, the sanctimonious holier-than-thou BS. Like, you don't care about the DM, you just don't like it for your own reasons. Like, get out. Session 1 rolls around, and once more he cuts everyone else off, tries to go first in everything, and constantly asks, would I be able to see slash hear slash make my way over there while X is doing Y? Just so they can get more time as the main character. Their character, a female warlock, constantly cut off characters mid-sentence and humble bragged about their powers. Normally, this is no problem, but this was after literally everything someone said. Oh, you're a changeling? I can just cast disguise self on myself. Honestly, your swordsmanship probably isn't that good. You probably couldn't even use a double-bladed scimitar like me, etc., etc. Viagra had also dumped strength and con, raising all other stats, which will be kind of important later, as when stopped at a bandit slash warlord checkpoint slash shakedown, the guys pretty much said to pay the fee of 5 gold each and we could be on our way no problem. Viagra, escalating the situation, claims that he could destroy the entire checkpoint using both magic and their double-bladed scimitar. The weird thing about that was that they were hellbent on using the actual double-bladed scimitar's stat block. which doesn't work with Hexblade's curse due to the two-handed properties, and never took the actual dual-wielding fighting style either. After asking the DM to roll an intimidation check and failing, the party was now on the verge of combat. The changeling essentially tells them they don't want to fight and how he'd pay for them. Yet Viagra basically goes, "No, I'm not going to let you walk all over me," and suddenly goes for an attack. I'll be honest, I was surprised since he managed to kill the first guy in one round and asked to roll another intimidation check. After being denied and everyone rolling initiative, the rest of the party chose not to get involved, opting to back up since our variant human rogue with alert went first and just said we weren't getting involved. Viagra was pissed that we refused to help and got to attack another guy since the bandits rolled decently low, missing the first attack and not being able to add the damage modifier to the second attack. The bandit survived, and the two guys attacked him. He uses shield, but one bandit crits after flanking him, and the other hits after rolling a 21. When Chloe says that he's been killed from the total damage, there was an audible slam noise on his end and a quick mute. He stayed muted for the rest of the game. After that, the bandits loot his corpse and says we can be on our way, and we make it to the next town over, and ending the session there. Seconds after it ends, Viagra leaves the call and writes a rant in the general chat about how he was targeted and you guys didn't step in to help me when I needed it. He claimed we were an awful group and bad to play with, and flat out left the server. Me and Chloe stalked his Reddit account for a few days to see if he posted anything about the situation, and read a comment he posted on an LFG post that basically went, "Yeah, I'd love to join. I'm a really good RPer and put lots of thought into my character. And really fun to be around. My last group kicked me out because they were kind of jealous of my character, because I actually put time and effort into it." TLDR, I joined my ex's campaign, make a goofy character that wants to stop the consumption of beef. Serious and hard-ass player makes everything about him and demands I make a new character. DMs the DM and offers 20 bucks in exchange for kicking me from the party. Dying in the first session after threatening non-hostile bandits. Blames it on us and leaves. I present to you the Pick Me D&D players, folks. But for real though, I've been fortunate not to play D&D with someone like this, but I've dealt with so many people like it in real life. They're the worst. Like, they put in effort and can have a decent product, so you can't just say they suck at it. But the way they handle themselves just makes them insufferable and not worth dealing with. Like I said before, it's good to be excited about your character, but if you then turn around and kick everyone else down, then you're garbage. I also can't stand it when one person dictates the direction for the rest of the party directly against their wishes. You see these players, "Oh, my character is chaotic whatever, and they have no control over themselves. They have to attack everything. Yeah, I watched Joker in Fight Club once, have no actual understanding of the characters, but am now basing my in-game personalities on this idea." It's a cooperative game. You have to work together. If you don't want to collaborate with other people, play a freaking video game. There's less effort to get together and less people have to deal with you. And if you really still want to play a TTRPG, find a system and a group that matches what you want. If you're wanting to just be super powerful and have the battle simulator, then 5e is not the game for you. Play some AD&D or DCC or any number of systems out there made more centered around combat. Then find other players who want that out of their games. So much in this space is finding the right personalities with the same want out of a game. Just stop forcing your play style on people who don't want it. Now again, I may have to put some blame on the DM, if they didn't set the expectation across the group so everyone was going in with the same frame of mind. Also, a side note, anytime someone says, "They kicked me out of jealousy," that is a red flag. If you're not sure, this is me telling you it's a red flag. No one kicks people out of jealousy. They may do other crappy things, maybe even with the hopes that you leave, but they're not going to kick you because your character is too awesome. What I think is truly the craziest part of this story is that it involved their ex, and that wasn't the point of the horror story. When the story starts out with, "I recently reconnected with my ex," you don't expect good things. But I think that's going to be enough horror for today. Now, this is normally where I put my Bearfacts, and they're still coming. But today, I think we're first going to take a peek into the Bearbard's Cave of Art and Wonders. Today's entry is from the infamous and fabulous Queen Siv, and is officially my ticket into Team Thurk. This is one of those honors that attaches glory to your name that will be there long after you're gone. But for real, I freaking love this. If you're ever wondering why I don't turn around on my channel normally, well, it's distracting having all this cake. And sometimes I have a tendency to just pop, lock, and drop it. Now, after you've been given that gift, let's go ahead with Bearfacts. The Kamchatka Peninsula on Russia's east coast is home of the densest bear population in the world. Making up that population is the Kamchatka brown bear, the largest brown bear in Eurasia. It is only surpassed worldwide by the Kodiak and the polar bears. The Kamchatka on its hind legs stands about 8 to 10 feet tall and weighs up to 1,430 pounds. They tend to be fairly solitary, avoiding both other bears and humans. They also tend to maintain a home of around 5 square miles, but can extend that when needing to access more food. Because they live in such a sparsely populated area, they are one of the few bear populations still thriving. Well, I think that's where I'm going to call it a day. I want to thank all of you for sticking with me till the end. If you like what you heard, make sure to give the channel a sub. If you want to support the channel further, you can look into my Ko-Fi, where you can sign up for a membership or a one-time tip. If you want to check out the Bear Bard in other forms, you can check out my Discord, Reddit, Facebook, Twitter, TikTok, and now Instagram, where I'll be posting all the amazing art I've received for this channel. Before we go, I just want to give a quick shout out to my new Ko-Fi sub, Armandeus, who is my first sub at the Big Bear tier, which means I now need to start producing my new mini show called Bear Bard's Final Thoughts, where I will give a quick recap and any final thoughts I came up with after recording and editing the video, which I tend to have a lot of. You get access to this at the Big Bear tier and up. I also can't forget my Mossies, Reuven Gritters, and Novatonics. Thank you guys for the support. It motivates me more than you know. For now though, I think that's it for me today. Remember to stay kind, stay beautiful, and keep on living that bard life.